this morning is kind of putting the cherry on the top of the Easter Sunday. Last week we declared that Jesus had risen from the dead, and with that made that final declaration that all of salvation had been secured. Sins had been forgiven, and we were now able to live as new people. But what I'm aware of after all these many years of living is that it's not enough to just simply know that God has forgiven us. It's also a time for us to forgive ourselves. Not as easy to do as it is to accept what God has done. And so the purpose of today's sermon is for us to feel that we can let go. Let go of the junk that we have carried. And to do that, we're going to invite you later on in the service to come forward and come down the center aisle, where Randy will be on the right side, I'll be on the left, mainly because I like the left side, but to then anoint you and to receive a blessing that you are free. And then you can return to your seats. So with that in mind, let's prepare ourselves to worship the Lord our God. Listen now to God's word, which first comes to us from the Psalms, David's Psalm, number 23. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore I shall not want. He makes me lie down in the pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You've prepared a table before me in the presence of all my enemies. You've anointed my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely, goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Thank you.
to hear God's word. Now coming from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 23. Listen, my friends, to the word of the Lord. On the evening of the first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them, and he said, "Peace be with you." Now after he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. And as the Father has sent me, I am now sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are indeed forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." This, my friends, is the word of the Lord. Shall we pray? Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of each of our hearts be found acceptable in your sight. Amen. When I was about 6 years old, my mom and dad, for whether it was my birthday or Christmas or whenever, bought me a radio flyer magazine. All I heard of remembrance, did you have one? A Little Red Wagon? Yes, these little critters. They were about 40 inches long, they were 18 inches wide, they were about 14 and a half inches tall, and they had this little black handle. Well, when I got mine, I couldn't hardly have it pried out of my little hand. I took it everywhere that I went. I'd come outside and I would pull my wagon. Wherever I had to go, I'd pull my wagon. It was 5 feet or 50 feet. It didn't make any difference. I pulled my wagon. And in the course of the day, I put everything imaginable into my wagon. I hauled pails of feed to the chickens and to the pigs and to the calves that I had to take care of. I gathered eggs and put them in the wagon to bring them to the house so my mother could begin to process them. Whatever had to be done. In fact, I even hauled the kittens so long as they would stay inside. And when the baby chicks came in the mail in boxes, I would put the boxes in my wagon and Dad would follow me out to the chicken house where he'd make sure I didn't hurt any of them. And we'd unload my wagon. I was a teamster from an early age and didn't even know it. Of course, when I wasn't hauling that kind of stuff, I was hauling my tractors and my wagons out to the sandbox where I could spend hours then playing the imaginary game of whatever. It was a wonderful life with my wagon. And on occasion, I would get to haul my sister, and my mom would be the backseat driver, telling me where I could go, how I could do it, and so she didn't wind up getting bounced out. And then there were those times when I hauled lots, and I hauled stuff. And you know, after a while, that wagon would get loaded, and it got to be harder and harder to pull. And on occasion, I'd have to go through, or I chose to go through, places that were not easily accommodated to my little red flyer or radio flyer. I'd have to go through mud or lumpy soil because maybe I'd try to pull it out into a plow field. And I'd struggle and I'd strain and I would pull it. And sometimes it got to be almost impossible for my little arms to pull the weight of that wagon through all that stuff. Now, that's a wonderful childhood remembrance. And I share it with you joyfully because as I read Psalm 23, I could not help but focus on that fourth verse. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Pulling my little red wagon sometimes got to be a very hard task because I'd fill it up too full and I couldn't pull all the way. And sometimes I tried to take it places where I should not have taken it, but there it was. I was in the midst of it and I couldn't get out. I remember how difficult it was. And oftentimes, as I'm struggling, and I would just try to, I'd get behind it and I'd try to push it. Well, you know how well that goes. It ended up that I needed help. And who was there but good old Dad? And Dad would then very carefully push. He'd say, you pull the wagon and I'm going to push. And we'd get it out of the mud and out of the junk. And sometimes he even had to unload my wagon so that it would move. Because I did not understand weight and all that junk. So there we are. He takes my burden off my wagon. And guess what? I'm able to walk the rest of the way out on the easy path. I remember that because that is what Psalm 23 is all about. I was one like a sheep who needed a shepherd, someone who would always have his eye on me. The Lord is our shepherd. I want you to stop and think about that. We oftentimes get ourselves lost. We don't know where to go. We don't know how to do it. We oftentimes get overburdened and overwhelmed. And it's difficult to sometimes get ourselves out and know where the end is going to be. And so there's our Lord. And he's watching us. And he's overseeing us. And like sheep, he is our shepherd. And because he is, we don't have anything that we need to worry about. Because you see, he gives us the best of what he's got. He brings us to the places where we can rest, the green pastures. He leads us beside the still water so we know we're going to be fresh and hydrated and made to feel good. And then he's going to guide me. Guide me in his paths, the paths of righteousness. Oh, how sweet it is to hear that. Because that's what my dad did to me. He made sure I got back out onto the path that would get me back home so that I could then do the things I wanted to do. And even though I walked through, and that's the important word in this, I walked through the valley of the shadow of death. And if you'll notice, when you read this in your Bibles, there's an asterisk. There's a little footnote right after that, you know, shadow of death. And if you read that footnote, it says, the valley of the shadow of hard times. So it's not limited to going through some death experience. It's called when times get tough and it hurts and we're struggling. God doesn't say, I'm going to give you a bypass so that you can avoid all this. I'm going to just somehow lift you up and move you over it so you don't have to deal with it. So I walk through this hard time. I'm not going to fear any evil because he's got my back. The Lord God is right there with me, and no matter how long it takes, no matter how much I may struggle, I'm not going to end my life or my experience there in the midst of it. It's not going to overwhelm me. Because my God is bigger than all the things that can happen to me in life. No matter how horrible they may be, no matter how ugly it may feel, God says, my life for you is better. What I have for you is bigger, and I will take care of you. So that even though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death or hard times, you don't have to be afraid. You may feel overwhelmed. You may feel a little beaten up. You may feel like you're just about not able to carry it on your own. But know this, you are with me, Lord. You are with me. And you bring your rod and your staff there to comfort me. He brings his all so that we can benefit from it. Whatever circumstance we're in, God's going to see that we get lifted up and carried through it so that it doesn't have to bury us and destroy us. Stop and think about this, that no matter who the enemy is, what the enemy is, God says, don't worry about it. I'm going to prepare a table before for you, a sumptuous meal in presence of your enemies. I'm going to anoint your head with oil as if you were royalty, as if you were a king or a queen. Your cup is going to overflow. Now stop and think about that. Here you are in the midst of going through all of this stuff. It doesn't feel very good. And God says, guess what? I'll be bringing you a blessing. You are a blessing. I'm bringing to you all of what I have so that you can feel blessed. So therefore, surely, goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life. No matter what you may have to go through, mercy and goodness is going to follow you all the days of your life. And know this, that at the end of the day, at the end of the trail, we're going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's a promise. That's a promise. If you put your faith in Him, who is the Good Shepherd, the one who is watching over His sheep all the time, providing for every single one of their needs, guess what? It's all going to end up, no matter where life takes us, no matter how hard it has become, we are going to end up in the house of the Lord. Forever. Now that gives me a warm, fuzzy kind of thought. Because sometimes that valley of the shadow of death has been of my own making. Decisions or choices I have made that weren't very good decisions and choices. I've messed up in my life. I think you have too. You know some places where you should have done something, you should have gone left and you didn't, and you went right, and as a result, it hurt. There are things that have occurred in your life that aren't yours to making, but they happened to you just the same, and it hurt. There are times when we have been bushwhacked by life, by people, by circumstances, and guess what? We had to live with the fallout of that. And it didn't feel good. Maybe it was even embarrassing. Maybe it wasn't just private embarrassment we felt, but public embarrassment as well. There's a whole myriad of things that could happen that are the shadow of hard times, tough times. But, God says, you don't have to fear any evil because I'm with you and I'm bringing my rod and my staff, that which can shepherd you and guide you and provide you direction and give you strength and lift you up. I'm bringing that. You got all of my resources so that you can have a quality life. Because you see, you're my precious child. And I love you. Shepherds love their sheep. And shepherds will do anything they can to make sure their sheep are safe. Making sure they have everything they need to survive and to thrive. You have that today. Last Sunday, I stood here and told you, you were forgiven. Jesus had gone to the cross, been placed in a grave, been raised up so that he not only could say he is risen, and we could celebrate that, but what does it represent? We are free from sin. He died on the cross so that each and every one of us would be free of that stuff that has drug us down. kind of like all those stones and rocks in my little red wagon that I could barely pull behind. Guess what? They got taken out. I can now pull that little red wagon, and I have freedom to do so and joy to do so. Well, that's what Jesus did. He took all the rocks, all that weight that you could not carry and should not have carried, but had to carry, and he took it off of you. And he said, no, I want you to live as free people. I want you to be at peace. Peace I give to you. That's what he says to his disciples. Peace be to each of you. Wow. No matter what they had done, remember, these are the very same disciples that abandoned him, ran away, denied him, and now sit in fear, not believing in what he had told them. And yet, this is the day he chooses to come and say, peace to you. That's what he's talking about with you today. Peace to you. Peace I want to give to you. I want to lift all that weight off of you. I want to give you freedom so that you can live as abundantly as it's possible to do. How much more joy could you have? Stop and think about this. If you weren't carrying some of that hidden stuff that you don't want to give up, that you won't forgive yourself for, or forgive others for, think how much joy, more joy you could find in your life if you didn't have that. Think of how much freer you could be if you didn't have to deal with that. Because that's what Jesus took away, and now you have to accept it and say, Lord, help me forgive myself, and let me be free. Let me truly feel like I have been anointed as if I were royalty. And let my cup, let me see my cup overflow. And truly, my friends, even right now, your cup is overflowing. It's unbelievable how it's splashing all over with blessing. And you shall have life. And you're going to have life. Now and for the rest of time, abundantly. But what's important is you set yourself free. Give yourself permission to be forgiven. God has forgiven you. Now take the next step and forgive yourself. My little red wagon, I love that thing. But every once in a while, it became a problem because I couldn't pull it. And I couldn't pull it by myself. I had to have help. My father came to help me. And now as a big boy who doesn't have a wagon, but who has a bunch of weight and stuff that I have to carry, I have a father who's willing to lift it off of me and to set me free so that I can live each day to its fullest. So right now, I'm inviting you to get rid of that stuff. Walk free. Walk joyfully. And know that you're going to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. God of grace, source of all healing, in Jesus Christ you heal the sick and you mend the broken. We bless you for this oil pressed from the fruits of the earth, given to us as a sign of healing and forgiveness, and the fullness of life will be given. By your Spirit, come upon all who are anointed with this oil, that they may receive your healing touch, and be made whole. For the glory of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer.
Amen.
As our Savior has taught us all to pray, let us pray together now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Jesus said, come to me, everyone who has labored and is heavy laden, and I will give you rest. In that spirit, come and be anointed. Do not hold back. Let God touch and heal your heart and your soul with his grace. Accept that today you can be a new person in Christ. So that you may love and serve him all the rest of your days and shall enjoy the fruit of eternal life. Amen.